happy Thanksgiving. Thanksgiving 2016. It's about 11:30 Central Time. And I'm taking a ride to Belleville. I was going to say, not a lot of traffic out today, but I may have spoken too soon. Thank you. leave already. Chatty this morning, reflecting on things from yesterday and feeling just a little quiet about it. Down on his luck, lonely and sad. Some guy, maybe a good Samaritan of sorts, put him on the bus and paid the fare. He was either sick or mentally incapacitated to some degree. You could have used a shower and a change of clothes. Driver stopped the bus and said, "This is your stop, buddy." And he got off pretty quickly, so it wasn't until after the fact that I realized I'm gonna use more help. Thank you. first got on the bus, I didn't pay much attention. I thought he was just some guy who didn't have fare. And some guy helped him out. Maybe he was lost, didn't know which bus to take, but how bad he smelled. I'm looking at him. Just had this awful, lonely, and scared look on his face. So I just hope he got home okay. I don't know where he was going. I can't think of anything worse than being alone and scared out of this world. Oh, I should have brought a Kleenex or a paper towel. My nose is burning. Now I'm getting warm. This is about the spot where I usually end up taking my coat or my jacket or something off. Moved over 4 miles. Yeah, 4.6. So I'll just have to ride slower. Anecdote. The anniversary of the passing of my Ruby is coming up. Dogs, which I dedicated my 10,000 miles this year to. Thank you. Oh, it's heavy feet. Happy thought number one. I wish my nose was stopped. Happy thought number two. My beautiful friend Bahar comes back to the United States. That reason will be because somebody showed them love and kindness. A number of my own. Six. Happy thought number six. Thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's goods. Wait, that's that crazy Bible stuff. Scratch that. Number six. No more crazy Bible stuff. How's that for a twist? Didn't see that coming, did you? Do I need anyway? I've done six. Happy thought number seven. Spending time. Today with my family and not having any arguments. Happy thought number eight. We're gonna do 10. Happy thought number eight. Religious people wake up and stop being religious people. Happy thought number nine. Shortcut. Happy thought number nine. not a lot of snow this winter. Let's see if we can walk across this rock pile. This one's gonna be easy, heavy about number 10. I get around this rock pile without having to go back and pedal up the hill and get sweaty. But that hill, back on the highway back there, would definitely make you sweaty. And at least until I'm done with my Thanksgiving events, I prefer not to be sweaty. Oh boy. Yeah, this is that crummy rock pile I walked over last time. So, I'm walking in these rocks with my bike. I don't know where that guy is going, but it's interesting that he went that way. And try not to get a bunch of junk in my shoes. Look at this, man. If I was a real hardcore mountain biker guy, I would just ride around that pile. There you go. Where there's a will, there's a way. And where there's a way, there's a way to go. Alright, I guess they're carrying more paper towels or something. Man. Speaking of where there's a will, there's a way. The concept of free will. I was thinking about that this morning. Free will. Fire at will. I think it's kind of rude. You're shooting at some dude named Will. I'd rather have free will than fire at will, but I don't make these things up. So free will, does it exist? Well, watching some of the videos on YouTube on crazy Christian evangelicals. happen when. Here's their contradictory argument. If you have free will, God loves you, he'll send you to hell if you sin, but you have a choice. Okay, why did God make hell? Why did he make us able to sin? It's part of his plan. Okay, so God has a plan, and I'm part of that plan. That plan was for me to sin. Plans work. Everything in that plan has to do exactly what it was designed or intended to do. Why? Christians will try to console you and say, well, it's all part of God's plan. Who can understand the mind of God? Thank you.